Very good morning to all of you. Myself, Hashmi S, and my colleague, Sarve SG, both of us are from MGM's College of Engineering, Nanded, Maharashtra. At the outset, I would like to thank my director, ma'am, Dr. Mrs. Geeta Latkar, and my chairman, Sri Kamal Kishore Ji Kadam, due to whom I am here. And I would like to also express our deep sense of gratitude to Dr. D.B. Fatak sir, who has accommodated us even after the online registration got closed down. So thank you, sir, for all that you did for us. Today, just a brief intro about our college. MGM started in 1984, and already we had completed 25 years. It started in 84 with just two streams, that is computer science and civil engineering, under the leadership of our chairman, sir, that is Kamal Kishore Ji Kadam, who was education minister, and he is an alumnus of IIT Bombay. And right now our campus is of 34 acres and it has got a strength of 1500 students. We have got 5 UG programs in different disciplines of engineering, and we have got 2 PG programs in engineering disciplines. And we are even collaborated with the Pittsburgh State University, US, for offering master's programs as well as UG programs over there. And we have even collaboration with Oracle, IBM, and Microsoft, and many more companies to provide training to the students and for the development of the infrastructure at our campus. Our college is affiliated to Swami Ramanand Tirth Marathwada University, which can be found on this URL, srtmu.n.ac.in. Now, going towards the syllabus of computer programming, in our university pattern, we have got 2 courses on computer programming. One is the fundamental of computer programming, which is common for all the branches. And after that is in second year, we have got OOPS programming, which is only for the IT and the CSE branches. So here we'll just look into the syllabus of this particular computer programming, which is common for all the branches. Now all the students, irrespective of the discipline, they will be studying this fundamentals of computer programming. This course is made up of 125 marks. And 80 marks are for the theory exams, which are conducted by the university, and tests, which are conducted at the college level, you can call the internal exams, which are of 20 marks, and the practicals, or the term work we call it, it is of 25 marks. Totally, the course is made up of 125 marks. Out of that, 80 marks are university exams, and 45 marks are at the college level. And this course, for this course, every week we have to conduct 4 hours of theory sessions, and 2 hours of practical are conducted for this particular course. The course is divided into 6 units. As you can see over there, the different units are there. Like you have unit 1, it talks about the computer fundamentals, and it will be covered in 6 hours. Unit 2, it talks about the data structures, it is covered in 6 hours. The third unit is for 8 hours, it talks about the arrays, and the fourth unit is about pointers, it is covered in 6 hours. And the next unit is on structures and unions, it is covered in 8 hours. And after that, the sixth unit is on file system, it is covered in 6 hours. Totally, the course is delivered in 40 hours duration in the whole semester. And the test which we conduct is after every 2 units. After completing 2 units, we have got the first test, and another 2 units, we have got the second test. And finally, after the rest of the 2 units, we have got the third test. Now, the textbook that is followed for this course by our university is Programming with C, by Venu Gopal, and another book is from Rakesh Agrawal, and the third one is Yashwant Connector, and there are a few reference books which are followed for this particular course. As far as practicals are concerned, we have got a list of 11 practicals, wherein in the first few practicals, we tell the students about the basics of the computers and the other peripheral devices. In the next session, we talk about the basics of the Unix, that is how to open a Unix and how to compile the programs in GCC and how to edit the programs in GCC. And then after that, the students go for implementing the different programs on the different concepts in the Unix programming, and in the C programming environment. Like we have got a couple of programs on loops and so on, like arrays. We have got a few programs on structures, unions, and so on. Here, just we gave the topic, we don't give a specific program. The reason behind is, if we give a specific, like you should write a program for computing perimeter of a particular thing, or if a problem statement is exclusively given as a list of programming assignments, what was happening, some in the nearby institutes or other small roadside shops, what they do, they prepare the solutions. And all 40 programs which are given completely, the solutions are ready-made available, and the students, they don't spare the time to write the programs on their own. And that's why here, the things are just vaguely written. You have to write the programs in on arrays. So for every semester, what array program will be there, it will differ from faculty to faculty. And that's why the chances of copying from other sources gets reduced, because the different institutes or the other vendors who want to provide some solutions, they don't know what type of programs are getting executed or getting conducted in that particular semester. So that was about the programming that we take in our college. Then regarding the evolution, that is evaluation pattern, we have the term work we call, it is internal 25 marks. Typically it is for the practical evaluation or maybe the programming evaluation. So therein we have got 20% is for the attendance, and 20% is for writing the journals, and the 20% marks are there for the assignments, and the 40% is for the viva. So the viva is conducted at the end of the semester based on the complete syllabus of that particular course or for the computer programming. And we have got progressive evaluation by conducting the test. As I told you, we conduct three tests, each one of 20 marks, and out of that, the best of two, that is the average, is taken. And the university papers, it is of 80 marks and it is of 3 hours, wherein there are 10 questions and the students have to attempt any 6. Again, that question, it depends on the question paper will have both the programming plus some theoretical stuff into that and other things. The computing facilities at our in a college, we have got 9 labs and we have got more than 250 IBM PCs. We are having EduSat lab already set up. We have got 7 servers from IBM. We have got 4 Mbps lease line, and the whole campus is connected by fast Ethernet and OFC connectivity. And I would like to show you the question papers which we have. This is the university papers that is conducted at the end of the SEM. Typically, it is for the 2009. As you can see here, it is of 80 marks and it is a 3-hour paper. Some instructions over there are given, and we have the paper is divided in 2 sections, section A and section B. Section A is of 40 marks and section B is of 40 marks. Typically, section A is on the first 3 units and section B is on the rest of the 3 units. Again, it is not essential that the sections should be covering that specific part. It depends on the faculties, those who design the question papers. Now, as you can see, this is the first question. Then we have got other questions over there, talks about the flowchart. Then we have got something related to the handling of the program. And then we have got a statement is given, and they have to write a program in C. And thing is given here, they have to generate an output which would look like this. Then we have got some handling, and this was one section. Here, again, we have got to write a program for addition of 2, 3 into 3 matrices, and again, handle of the program. And here, we have got a section B, wherein some theory questions are there, and after that, you have got a few programs given. The students have to write the programs. Then this is the 10 questions we have got. So this is the fundamental course, which is compulsory for all the branches. Apart from this, in our campus, we have got the BCS, we have got the MCS. Even they have got a computer programming, that is a fundamental course, with a little bit variations here and there. But in my campus, every semester or every year, I can say, nearly 700 to 800 students are undertaking a course on computer programming, that is fundamentals of computer programming, and basically using C only. But for the next semesters, only the computer and the IT students will go for object-oriented programming concepts, and maybe C++ or using Java.
What do you mean by the journal writing?
the students, like whatever programs are they are supposed to write, first of all they have to write the logic of that. A statement is given, okay, you will be given like write a program to print the mark sheet of the students. So that will be the problem assignment statement, and in that they will write the logic, what way they are going to have. They may write an algorithm for that particular program, and after that they may even draw the flow chart for that program, and then they will come to the lab. In the lab they will do the coding, they will take the they will execute the program, and they will show the output to the faculty, and then they have to take the printout of that particular program, and that printout plus the other stuff that they have written related to that program, that will be their one programming assignment. So in this way, for the whole semester they will be doing somewhere around 30 to 35 different programming assignments, and that will be put together in a file in a journal, and that will be submitted to the department. Yeah, it will be similar to the project record. No, because the term in our university, this term is being used since quite long. The file that is prepared is called as a journal. So of course when we talk about the research, the journal is something different. It's not in that context. Yeah, we divide. Yeah, we have like minimum 75 is compulsory, and above 75, like if student has got 90% and above, he will be getting 5 marks, 5 out of 5, because it is for 25 marks, and that's why as the attendance works out to be 5 marks. And if they are somewhere between 85 to 90, he gets 4 marks. Then 80 to 85, he'll be getting 3 marks, and 75 and above, he'll be getting 2 marks. That way we have the division of the marks for the attendance.
This is one question not only to you but to everybody else. This first course, typically what is the percentage of students who fail? How much? 50.
So sir, I disagree with him.
No, it will vary. Yeah. But in your university is 50%. What about Nanded? For undergraduate. No, no, I'm talking about the first course in programming. Just this first, no, I'm not talking about general failure. This subject, programming.
Like sir, in our case, it is somewhere around 30 to 35%, not more than that. Like 70% or sometimes 75%.
30 to 35%. One third, roughly.
Roughly.
20%. Here is a question that I have as a teacher. Let's say it varies between 20 to 50%, which is non-zero. Now, if a first-year student comes to my college who has no clue about programming, not required to know programming, and if the student fails, who is responsible, student or teacher? If a single student fails, there is some problem with that. We also have failures, by the way. But
sir,
the point is, does our system, not just the teachers, but the system as a college, university, do we take this accountability or responsibility? Is there any serious discussion every year as to how you can reduce the failure?
Yeah, and, at our college we have this thing.
So like, what is the feedback mechanism? Meaning, does it,
so
net outcome, for example, I can understand first time when you start a course, there would have, let's say, 25% failure. Over the last 5 years, the percentage has remained same. Then there is some concern.
Yeah, that's, it varies.
Vacation batch. Well, that's the makeup class.
So okay. Normally what we say is, if we simply push the student and make them pass, since we, ours is a deemed university, the evaluation is in our own hands. But we never do that because the students will never learn anything.
No, 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 100%. That's not the point. The point is not passing them.
No, no. What we do is, we conduct vacation classes, and we have extra lab, because during vacation time, they'll be learning only this for 20, 25 days. Okay. So they can really understand the basic concepts, and then they pass.
So they can give something like a repeat course
Like they have to repeat the course.
No, that is there everywhere. Even IIT, same thing, that if you flunk a course, you'll have to re-register for it sometime. We don't,
after supplementary, if they failed, they have to repeat the course.
You may have supplementary or whatever. The issue is, I like that approach better, where you have a summer vacation class, because supplementary means that student is only reappearing for evaluation. Whereas actually the reason that student failed is because student was not adequately prepared.
Now our supplementary is for a genuine reason. If they have medical reason, if they fail to appear for the end semester exam, we give supplementary. Yeah, but it's not for a real failure case. No.
So here is a question, because if I see the number of classes, for example, number of lectures or the labs, very well defined, sufficient number of hours, etc., etc. Yet if such large number of students fail, what is it that we are missing as teachers?
Sir, I would like to add one point to this, because in our admission system, because typically in Maharashtra state, what happens, the admission, they are centralized. So like in the first, we have got multiple rounds of the admission process.
Oh, the colleges start late in the first.
Yeah, the college start early, but the students gets admitted late. Because what happens in first round?
I mean, the lectures start late.
The lectures are started in the beginning only. Students come, yeah.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, that's like, okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.